Hi, Ari, it's Stravsnir, and welcome back to our adventures in Azeroth. Last episode, we got our territory standing up, did some town board quests. We also checked out the crops in Monarch Bluffs to make sure they were alright. Let's try to get rid of some stuff here, though. Clearly have a decent amount of items we need to get rid of. See what we got here. Got some pants we won't use. We got some juniper berries. We got a little bit of coin. That's good. Alright, so we have some iron to smelt. We'll just throw this stuff out for now. Alright, so let's go check the town board. And we'll keep leveling up to 40, and hopefully we can get our territory standing up at the same time. Maybe we'll see what she wants to do up there. So we gotta get some wood. Explorers needed, we'll pick that up. 50 iron ingots. I don't know if I would be willing to actually give that away. It's a lot of iron to give away just for a little bit of coin and some territory standing. But I guess we actually have this completed. Should we just complete it? Whatever. We're gonna take it. Whatever. We're desperate. We'll get more iron. Not too worried about it.
If the farms overrun by wizards still have healthy crops, then we must harvest them. We might even be able to use this as leverage.
Leverage for what?
Think about it. If the crops are failing in the territories of our neighbors, they're desperate. We can supply them with our healthy crops, and they'll thank us for it.
It could win us some allies.
Better yet, an obscene profit. In fact, the old Aruda ranch was famous for its delicious jam. Go clear the wizard there, and see if you can find some unspoiled jam. It would be quite a boon. Visit Aruda Ranch and try to find some of that famous jam they made. If it's unspoiled, we're in luck.
Alright, so looks like we gotta go jam hunting. And I guess we'll pick up some... Should we pick up PvP quests? It doesn't matter. Really deep. We're just gonna go down here. I'm gonna do this, that, and that. We don't really need to get the PvP quests. Problem with the PvP quest is that if you fast travel back, then you lose them all. And that makes sense because you have PvP on. I think once we run out of quests to do in Monarch Bluffs, like the side quests, then we'll start combining PvP quests with town board. But until then, we'll just do town board quests with the side quests for now. I think we should hit level 37 today. I'm hoping we do. Gotta collect some wood. Good thing now. And I think we gotta get the young tree wood. I didn't know that it was different. Mature, just, the wood you got from mature trees versus the wood you got from young trees. I think we need like 500 of the green wood. I think we need to find goats or sheep or something like that. Alright, so we'll head down this way. Pretty nice day in Monarch Bluffs. I wonder what territory standing we're at. Almost at 15. Which means we could buy the $10,000 homes and we can get them for $5,000. It's crazy how high of a territory standing you need just to get the nice homes. That's one thing that this game does. It really makes you grind for for everything. Which is an MMO, right? They try to time gate you as much as they can. I think it should have just been 15. You can buy all the houses. 30 territory standing is kind of wild. Like, we've done a lot in this place, man. The thing is, I could just buy, like, a smaller home, but it would suck to miss out on that extra 5,000 gold. Like, it's hard to get thousands of gold. Like, I'm only at... I'm a low level, but I'm only at, well, I'm at 12,000, so 5,000 isn't that bad. I hope we can do a PvP fight soon. I haven't had one of those in a while. You know what I think this game should add? Like a battleground. That would have been fun, man. I think that's what it's missing. It really needs like a battleground system. Or just a couple of like, you know, organized like games you can play. Just to get you off of the, you know, the leveling grind for a little bit. So I think we have to find chests here. Is that what we want? Shuttle? Yeah. We're looking for shuttle. How much we need? 8? Let's see. Town projects. Oh, we have a lot. We have over 25. I'm guessing between 5 and 8. They're all coming down. They're coming in here. There we go. Okay, so let's see if that was enough. Yep, 5 is enough. Good guess. Alright, so let's move south and we'll head to the first quest here. Goodwill squashing. Harvest a prize squash from Trey Campos. Then after that, we will do the second quest. Is the Aruda Jam quest. Try to find that. And then we'll chop some wood for a bit. Try to get enough wood to turn in for the town board quest. Okay, so here we are. I wonder if we find the squash here. We have to harvest. So we gotta find some sort of a farm. Oh yeah, right over here should be a spot. Did a lot of damage. Let's see if we can find the prize squash. I think we have to go exactly where they're telling us to go. Oh, so we have to defeat Withered here. Okay. Then we have to harvest a squash. Is that it? No. It's just a provisions crate. Let's see what this is. It is wonderful to now have neighbors. Our shared toil has enriched the lives of all of us. Fourth year harvest is just around the bend, and my heart soars. Alright, so looks like they were building a little farming community here. Everyone was getting along. And then corruption came, I guess. Still haven't been able to find a squash to harvest. Oh, they're over here. I think we have harvesting. We got one more here. And there we go. Now we just got to get this Aruta jam. Funny because a lot of the quests we've been doing in Monarch Bus has been all about food. Okay, so we found a jar of jam here. Seemed like that Withered was enjoying it. It's kind of a weird looking jam. It's like green. I don't know if I've ever seen a green jam before. Blueberry jam's pretty good. I think that might be my favorite jam. And then there's like the orange jam marmalade. I'm not a big fan of it, but it's not bad. Oh man, this guy just puked a bunch of jam on me. There's actually, I've seen this, like, on Twitter. There's people who actually make the food in the game. Like, I think they, like, take the recipes, or maybe they make their own. And they try to make the food in the game. I wonder what, like, a Aruta jam would be. That'd be cool if they did that. If they, like, gave the recipes to all of this stuff. Alright, let's check this out. Some madman attacked me. He was crazed and wild. with red eyes that struck fear in my heart. I held him back with my pitchfork, and he ran away. The stink coming off of him is one I will not soon forget. Now that stench won't come off my pitchfork, no matter how many times I watch it. I wash it, Thomas. Yeah, they were just, you know, minding their business, I guess, and then they got attacked by the corrupted. I wonder if the corrupted and the withered are just people who try to come here from the outside world. And they just, you know, they go insane. Yeah, we'll just chop some trees now. Try to get 500 green wood. I wonder what the upgrade for axes are. We have an iron axe. But I assume there's probably a better metal source that we can find. But we gave away a lot of our iron, so it might take us some time to get back up there. I think this axe is doing a pretty good job, though. There's a skill to proper tipping. I don't know what that means. Collect 4,000 wood using a logging axe. I think we need 500. Pretty sure. I don't think it was 50. That's a little... It's not that much. Nope, this guy's gonna attack us while we're chopping this tree, probably. Nope, he's going inside. Smart move. Sometimes I think the withered are just... You know, a peaceful group of people. They just don't like us humans. Hey, look, he's like working on the farm right there. They're all just minding their own business. Hopefully we have enough carrying space. Yeah, we got enough. Halfway to where we want to be. Like, if you just look at the withered, they're just minding their own business. Planting stuff, eating stuff up, eating grass. I don't know what they're eating. What are you get at, like, 100, like... Once you hit, like, 100 of logging, like, what type of trees can you chop down? There has to be, like, some mystical trees out there. Like, I've seen a lot of weird ores and plants. But I haven't seen any, like, weird trees yet. And I assume there is some. Like, probably see some eventually. Alright, so 100 more green wood to go, and well, we should be ready to turn in that quest. Happy we got to mature trees. Took us a while. Let's chop one down here. I wonder what those things are, those, like, monsters. Maybe that's what happened to their dogs. Their dogs just turned into those abominations. supposedly it's a good thing to do is for the town board quests to put the items that are required for the daily town board quests on the trading post. Supposedly they sell pretty quick. There's probably people farming territory standing in every town, I would assume. Trying to get it up. Okay, so let's hearth out of here. Or fast travel out of here. Okay, so let's see if we can turn these in. Got the jam quest. And we have a couple of town board quests to turn in. There we go, level 37, not bad. Check out some upgrades here. I guess we'll keep going into strength since we're almost at 100. And looks like we got a territory standing. Nice. So what do we want to do? Trading taxes? Storage. Yeah, storage would be pretty good. Faction reputation. Earn more faction rep while in Marnark Bluffs. I think that would be good. Because that is what we are currently doing.
Oh my goodness, look at this. Aruda jam. Oh, the most delicious. And this stuff goes a long way. This will keep our settlement fed and then some.
All right, not bad.
As you know, I had anticipated selling the Aruda jam you acquired to our neighboring settlements. But I have had a change of heart.
All right. Well, there we go. Looks like she's holding on to the Aruda jam for herself. Must be pretty good. If I can jump down here. Now we have to turn in another quest. I think the squash quest. I'm not sure who we turn that squash quest into. It's probably here. Yeah, where do we turn in that squash quest?
Gotta admit, sharing this knowledge with Windsward makes me nervous. But it's the right thing.
Oh, okay, so we gotta go to Windsward. That is where we gotta turn in the squash quest. Well, I guess we'll just hold on to that for now. And we'll put some stuff away in the storage here. We got some coin and some juniper berries. Let's get rid of this stuff. I wish they had, like, a mass salvage. Just so you can quickly get rid of all this stuff. There we go. Alright, we're almost full storage, so we might have to get rid of some stuff eventually. But I'm going to be calling this episode here, guys. Next episode, we will continue leveling up, closing in on 40, and then we can get back to the main story quest chain. But as always, thanks for watching. Keep your heads up. Later.